By and large, I think that the community has always loved their police officers.
Walking the halls of the Toler Police Department is like going back in time with former Assistant Police Chief Bob Bond and current Public Information Officer Don Martin.
We're part of the family. We're part of that blue family.
Photos of the past line the walls, like this one showing Ronald Reagan campaigning in Toler.
Bill Gekin, yeah. Herbert Hyder, Charles Chandler, and that's Tony Nash, I think.
The history of the Toler Police Department goes back to 1909 when the city hired the first police officer, J.J. Ray, who later became the first chief in 1916. Officers in the early years mainly received on-the-job training and faced many challenges in the field due to limited technology.
You know, we didn't even have walkie-talkies. We got out of the car, we were on our own.
We have tasers today. We didn't have those back when I started. Back then it was basically a broomstick that we called a nightstick. And I know before then it was even slappers.
This photo from 1932 shows the first motorcycle officers. In 1955, the first African-American officers were hired, and in 1976, the first women joined the department.
The uniform, it means something. It takes a special person, as you know, to be a police officer.
There's been many changes in everything from the uniform to the badge, and even the vehicle. At one point, Toler PD experimented with yellow police cars, while today, you see the standard white being used.
The history of the Toler Police Department means a lot to me. Because you see, I was part of it from 1970 to 1976.
Many more milestones were reached throughout the years, from the first mobile crime lab, creating a SWAT team, to using dogs as canine officers.
I feel privileged, again, really, to be a part of it. I felt that we had a great department.
Toler has had four officers killed in the line of duty. In 1946, Malcolm Bowie was stabbed while pursuing a suspect. In 1955, Burl Whittington was killed in a traffic accident while chasing a suspect, as was Miles Nickel in 1962. And Eugene Vickers was fatally hit by a car in 1963 while working an accident.
When you come to work, you never know what your day's gonna hold. It can switch like that of what's gonna happen.
They don't know when they go to work. None of us know we have a tomorrow, but it's much enhanced with these police officers.
Over the years, Toler PD has grown from a few officers to 194.
If the public really understood all the things that we go through just to become a police officer, I think there would even be a greater respect saying, wow, thank you for what you do.
A commitment that each one wears, like the uniform and the badge at the start of each shift.
We ask God that you continue to protect us. Bring us home safely to our families as we go out and do our jobs to the best of our ability.
For CBS 19, I'm J.B. Smith.
We ask you in your son's holy name. Amen.
And that's my story.